In this tutorial, we'll show you how graphic designers can use Canto Brand Templates. This allows them to set up InDesign files in a way that allows approved end users to change specific text and images within a layout while keeping control over brand design restrictions. First, you'll want to install the Brand Template add-on and log in with your credentials here in InDesign. In this example, we'll open an existing InDesign file and then click on Initialize Template here on the panel. This will make some changes to your document to ensure compatibility with the cloud service. The most visible change will be the creation of a background layer in your document. Move the layers and objects that you want to be fixed and not editable by the end user into the background layer. Outside the background layer, you may apply the lock icon to any objects or layers so that editors can swap content like images or text edits, but they won't be able to move or resize these elements. Once the designer is done, then save the file. After you save it, then click Preflight to check the validity of the document. If there aren't any errors, then click Package and then upload it to the Print UI server. By default, once you click Upload, it will appear in your Canto main library and the Document Smart Album is seen here. When you're ready for end users to make changes, it's a great idea to assign the brand template to a portal. You do this by making sure that your BT file is assigned to an album that's connected to a portal. At this point, the end user can make all the changes they need in a simple web browser interface with no InDesign knowledge needed, and then download the new PDF, JPEG, PNG, or package file. See our other video on how end users can edit layouts using brand templates to see how end users can make select changes. Thanks for watching.